Hello friends, I am Dr. Sagar Bhattad, a pediatric immunologist based in Aster CMI Hospital, Bangalore. And today in this presentation, I would like to present a few cases regarding a group of conditions called primary immune deficiency disorders. So, what are primary immune deficiency disorders? These are a group of genetic diseases wherein the immune system is at defect and children fall sick again and again due to this defect. In the coming presentation, we'll have a clinical approach to these group of conditions. Primary immune deficiency diseases are not rare. They are in fact common, but unfortunately they are grossly misdiagnosed and many a times underdiagnosed. So, when it comes to primary immune deficiency diseases, the most common amongst these are the B cell disorders, and today we shall have a clinical approach to what is known as humoral immune deficiency. How does one suspect immune deficiency in one's clinical practice? To increase this awareness amongst the doctors, amongst the public, Jeffrey Model Foundation has come up with warning signs. Now, this is a foundation based in New York and has given these warning signs. So, what are these warning signs? If a child has got repeated ear infections, one should think of immune deficiency. Repeated sinus infections, think of immune deficiency. If a child is requiring 2 or longer months of antibiotics to clear infections, think of immune deficiency. Repeated episodes of pneumonia, one should work up these children for immune deficiency. And if a child does not grow, if there is failure to thrive, that means they are not gaining weight and height as per their age norms, think of immune deficiency. Recurrent deep-seated abscesses like the liver abscess, the lung abscess, one should work up for immune deficiency. Persistent thrush warrants an evaluation. And then, if then there are deep-seated infections, you should think of immune deficiency. A family history of immune deficiency. For example, if a family has lost 2 or more children in the past, and this is the third child coming to you with a serious infection, think of immune deficiency. If one applies these warning signs in day-to-day practice, we can all diagnose immune deficiency very easily. Let's look at a real-life scenario. A 4-year-old boy who came to us with the third episode of pneumonia requiring hospitalization. In the past, he had 2 episodes of ear discharge as well. Look at the chest X-ray, there are infiltrates on both the sides. Now, as pediatricians, we have been trained. When you see recurrent pneumonia, you need to think of congenital heart defects, think of anatomical lung defects, think of cystic fibrosis, think of aspiration syndromes. But then, in this child, on thorough clinical examination, we noted something interesting. The tonsils were missing. In a 4-year-old boy, absent tonsils means a bedside diagnosis, and that's X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. How do you confirm this diagnosis? Send an immunoglobulin profile, which consists of serum immunoglobulin IgG, IgA and IgM. And look at this kid, all the immunoglobulins were absent. And then this was followed by a B cell count, and the B cells were completely absent, confirming the diagnosis of X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. Now the second case, a 1.5-year-old boy came to us with high grade fever and eye swelling, and this boy was diagnosed to have orbital cellulitis. We asked for the history in the past, there was nothing significant, but then when we looked into the family tree, there was something interesting. The maternal uncle was deaf, and we realized that he had meningitis at young age and had had repeated episodes of ear discharge and lung infections, and this story made us think of an X-linked background. And because of this family background, we asked for an immunoglobulin profile, and you can again see all the immunoglobulins were missing, the B cells were absent, and the boy was diagnosed with X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. And believe me, the maternal uncle at the age of 21 was diagnosed with X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. So, the third case of the day. A 3.5-year-old boy was first hospitalized at the age of 1 in some hospital in Bangalore. He presented with fever, had encephalopathy and was in hypotensive shock. The pediatricians tried all kinds of antimicrobials, but the boy would not recover. And then, as a desperate situation, they gave him a dose of intravenous immunoglobulin and the boy recovered. Unfortunately, 6 months later, the boy had another episode of pneumonia and was again hospitalized, this time recovered after a course of antibiotics. And now, he was hospitalized at Aster with high-grade fever and neutropenia. And I remember my friend, my colleague called me up and said, there is something wrong with this boy because he comes to me again and again. And it is this suspicion that made him call me. And we asked for an immunoglobulin profile, and you can see all the immunoglobulins were missing, the B cells were absent, and the boy was diagnosed with X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. So friends, now you have seen three cases with X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. So what is X-linked A-gamma globulinemia? It's a prototype of the humoral immune deficiency wherein the B cells are completely absent, and that is why these children do not have immunoglobulins. Because it is X-linked, it is boys that are affected. However, most of the infants will remain asymptomatic in the first 6 months of life because of maternally transmitted immunoglobulins. Look at boys who come to with recurrent infections. Look at the tonsils, lymph nodes. If you don't see tonsils, if the lymph nodes are absent, you have made a diagnosis, and that is X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. I am often asked whether it is easy to diagnose immune deficiencies, and I say yes, because this is a simple algorithm for the diagnosis. If you suspect an immune deficiency, please look at the immunoglobulins. If the immunoglobulins are missing, if there is hypogammaglobulinemia, look at the B cell count. The B cell count is absent, that's X-linked A-gamma globulinemia. If there is low immunoglobulins and the B cells are present, and that's common variable immune deficiency. I would speak on common variable immune deficiency some other day. But now this algorithm is quite simple and will be helpful. The message that I would like to give you from this brief presentation is that when you see children coming to you with recurrent pneumonia, coming to you with recurrent or persistent diarrhea, children who come to you with repeated ear discharge, or if you see a child with bronchiectasis and you don't know why he developed this, please look at the serum immunoglobulins. Serum IgG, IgA, IgM are cost effective tests in this setting, and this simple test can virtually make the diagnosis and change the treatment paradigm for these children.